Okay, let's try this again, and we are going to mulligan this hand. Okay, not enough blue. We do have a divination, however, and we have 21 blue sources in the deck, and I don't really want to go to 5 here, so we're kind of just banking on the fact that if we draw, for example, a white source of mana, we can cast Divining Light. And if we draw a blue, then we can play Divination. And if we don't draw any, then we just lose the game. So I think I would rather keep this just because, you know, there is high potential that, for example, if we just draw one island in the next two draw steps, or sorry, next three draw steps, that we're actually going to be looking just fine. Okay. So yeah, we're going to choose to keep here and just lead with the planes. I think with Radiant Fountains, it's just better. You don't need to play right away. It's better to slow roll it unless you're in danger of losing, because you want your colored mana. Having colored mana is way more important early on. So, our opponent leading off with the Temple of Malady. All right. Well, we have no choice. So, look, we even made the decision to cut one of the four Radiant Fountains to make our mana better. That is a risk you take by playing so many of these. When I was initially playing this deck, I only had 2 copies of it, but I guess he did not like losing to the red decks very often. I'm not gonna lie, when you get to the late games though, being able to play these lands, I mean, these lands do a lot of work. Alright, what is he taking? It looks like we're playing against Sadisi Whip, and he puts Forest in his hand, so let's do this for now. Alright, sweet. So we drew our blue source. Let's go ahead and cast Divination. So allow us to smooth out our draw. Alright, those are a couple of good cards. Still do need another blue or a white source, but we have 2 turns because we can cast Banishing Light. Main deck Ashiok. Okay. Where does it... Why isn't... Oh, here it is. So he's got Tranquil Cove. Man, that would have been sweet. Banishing Light and Dig Through Time. All right, I guess we're going to go ahead and Banishing Light this. Oh, that was a sweet draw. The perfect draw, if you will. Don't want to get decked. And let's go ahead and play the Temple. And we want this island. No, I do not. We have another draw step on a land. We're not going to miss a land drop. And now we have both 2 blue and 2 white. So one of the problematic cards... this matchup is supposed to be pretty decent. The fact that more people are playing main deck Reclamation Sages and Sultai Charms does hurt this deck because we rely so heavily on Banishing Light to deal with threats. And also Soul of Innistrad. If he happens to be playing Soul of Innistrad, that is also very problematic for us. Alright. And, well, we use a Banishing Light on Ashiok and now he has Whip, but fortunately, he has nothing awesome to whip into play right now, so we can't cast his dig just yet. We need to dissolve something first. We're not going to be using Devouring Light on Seder Wayfinder. He's got to have a relevant threat to play this turn, though. I'm surprised. I mean, I guess he really, really wanted to stick the Whip of Erebos, but... And maybe he wanted to play around End Hostilities? I feel like we're just snap dissolving this pretty much no matter what. Unless it's a Sylvan Caryatid. Alright. You got me. Huh. The Seder Wayfinder, though. That could be problematic. I'm going to counter that one, because right now he doesn't have any good threats in his yard for the Whip of Erebos. Sure, I'll keep that on top. It just buys us time, because basically I want to be at a high enough life total, so that we can cast our Victory Time and then stabilize with the Wrath and, you know, hopefully find another Banishing Light for the Whip of Erebos. He can return to Wayfinder, but while that's really good, like I said before, it doesn't really put on any pressure. So all right, we'll let that resolve, and that's a Hornet Queen. Okay, so I don't mind too much that he draws the Hornet Queen, but we'll cast a Dig Through Time here first and see where we're at before we decide whether or not we want to Wrath this coming turn. So I certainly want a land. Do I actually? Is it certain? Is it certain that I want this land? Banishing Light on the Whip of Erebos seems pretty good. I don't think Elspeth is necessary just yet, so it's possible that I want something like Banishing Light plus a card draw spell. Because Banishing Light on the Whip does seem pretty strong. Yeah, I don't need the Elspeth right now. I just want to run him out of the cards in his hands first before taking over the game. So if I wanted to do that, we have enough counter spells. Banishing Light's one. Jace's Ingenuity allows us to just continue, you know, outcarding our opponent. So yeah, I'll take Banishing Light, Jace's Ingenuity. We'll go Elspeth, Nullify, and some lands. Alright, now I'm going to go ahead and cast Banishing Light on the Whip of Erebos, and we'll still have Counterspell up. I don't really care about the creatures that he has on the board right now, and I kind of want to be able to cast an End Hostilities and then keep up Disdainful Stroke. He's got a Hornet Queen, which he cannot cast yet. Still have these two counter spells. It's a DC. Yeah. I'm gonna actually dissolve this, because I'm looking for a land here. All right. Well, I will keep the dissolve. The reason why I dissolved it is, once again, the creatures that he has on the board is not a huge threat, but the Sidisi is. However, if I do choose to, tap out there, if I let the Sidisi resolve and cast an End Hostilities, he can make me pay by playing something like a Whip of Erebos. Although here, I think I'm going to go for the main phase Jace's Ingenuity to find an untapped land. I think there's a very good chance that we can do that. And boom. All right. So this is looking pretty good for us. So it's very likely that he goes ahead and plays another threat this following turn. So, you know, it might be a courser, or I don't know. I mean, I guess he can choose to just go with the three damage us and pass plan, but I don't think that just gives us too much time, because then we can untap and just draw more cards. So there's the Whip of Erebos, which we were talking about earlier. So that makes me feel a little bit better about all of this. Let's just get islands, more counters. Let's cast Disdainful Stroke. So once again, we don't need to cast End Hostilities. This does not pose enough of a threat. So we did draw the Flooded Strand. I want to be able to cast Dissolve and Jace's Ingenuity on the same turn, so I'm going to choose not to cast the Temple of Enlightenment, or play the Temple of Enlightenment, rather. So far we know that he has Cut, Courser, and Queen. And he has yet to hit a land off the Courser, so that's pretty unlucky for him. Alright, so let's go ahead and crack this. Fetch the planes this time, because now we have four blue sources, which is the ideal number. Okay. Now we can 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we can play an Elspeth, actually, and keep up Dissolve. So I think we're going to go ahead and do that, because once again, his board, not really worth wrathing. This might induce him to play something like a Doomwake Giant, for example. I suppose I could have cast Devouring Light on his guy, but eh. Okay, Hero's Downfall. We'll let that resolve. We have plenty of Elspeths in our deck. We're in no huge rush. So now he has two Queens and a Cut coming up. I didn't even think about it, but there is some synergy here with the Elspeth and Devouring Light. The question is, do I want to cast the Devouring Light here? Because we have a couple of End Hostilities that we should probably be firing off at this point. But so maybe it's better just to save this Devouring Light. I mean, actually, blocking here and Devouring Lighting this doesn't seem that bad. No, but then he plays a Courser, and then I don't want to just have to End Hostilities that. Alright, let's just chump and save the Devouring Light. We have plenty of mana at this point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Still don't need to Wrath. Guess we'll go ahead and play a Divination. Don't want to play the Elspeth and let myself be vulnerable to another whip if he has it, although it's very unlikely that he does. So I'm just going to play the Temple. And let's bottom that. He has Cut. He has not hit off a single Courser. Knowing that he has Downfall is kind of unfortunate. We might counter that one. Alright. Elspeth. Boom, you hit a land. Oh, there's a Soul of Innistrad. Okay. All right, I feel like I might want to be switching gears here and kind of start being aggressive. He has a lot of cards in his hand, but they don't do anything. I'm gonna try to like go all in on this Elspeth here. If he plays a courser, we nullify. If he plays a downfall, we dissolve. This time. All right. Yeah, this can actually win the game in a hurry if he doesn't have anything. So courser, actually, you know what? I'm not gonna nullify that. I think I might wanna just hold out for a Doomwake Giant. Cause we can also nullify the Hornet Queen that he plays next turn. And this just puts a lot more pressure on him. Yeah, like he's got a lot of spot removal in his hand, but ooh, that was an excellent draw. All right, Humph. So this gets in for 4. Next turn, we ultimate the Elspeth, and that should be it. He probably doesn't want to draw that land. Probably doesn't want to draw that land either. Probably getting a swamp. Yeah. Alright, well. There's a Doomwake Giant. My guess is he's going to play Hornet Queen this turn. So even if he has one removal, he's just dead. All right. Protect the Elspeth. Maybe we could have fired off in End Hostilities at some point earlier in the game, but that it didn't really come up. So. All right. What do I want in this matchup? I don't think I want Brimas. I don't think that he does enough, because I just want to be sweeping the board. It does do a reasonable job of blocking stuff like Courser of Krufix and Sidisi, though. Alright, definitely don't want these 5 cards. We have enough counter spells where we don't need to really bring in the negate. Erase is pretty good. Like, I'm almost tempted to like board out the Banishing Lights because of all the enchantment removal that they could have, but you know, maybe taking out a couple is correct. I don't think Last Breath is great. The only thing it gets is Courser of Krufix. Like, there's no other creature that it deals with. And he's playing Sidisi, not Eidolon of Blossoms, so Last Breath is even worse. Yeah, Erase definitely comes in. I guess maybe we just need to keep the Banishing Lights just because of all the Planeswalkers that he has. Fate of Retribution is definitely good. And what do we take out? What's the last card? I mean, Devouring Light also seems kind of... It does not seem like the best. Thank you. Let's see. I like the erases. I like the strokes and the nullifies. I like the card draw because you want to be ahead, and that's what allows you to get ahead. The planeswalkers. Then there's Prolake Ancient. Is Prolake Ancient necessary? Probably. It's probably like a good inevitable, or it provides inevitability. Alright, we'll cut one of the Devouring Lights, I guess. His deck's not that aggressive, and if he's attacking me with a DC, that's not really where we want to be. But I'll keep one in. A Miser's Light.